Hi folks, Astronomy Live here. A few years ago, I created a spreadsheet for calculating the apparent orientation of the Moon for an arbitrary observer on Earth at any given time. Now, this was used to explain field rotation, and in particular, why the Moon can sometimes look horizontal in appearance, as seen in this photo taken in 1971. You can see the Apollo Saturn V rocket on the pad, and behind it, a horizontal crescent moon setting in the distance. It's been a few years since I've covered it, and the question has come up again in the comments asking if this is normal, and indeed it is, despite those saying otherwise. But I don't want to just retread old ground by bringing out the old spreadsheet again. Instead, I've created a new tool using Python to create a program that will automatically derotate images of the moon to return the lunar terminator to a vertical orientation using the observer's location and the time. I've uploaded the source code for this program to GitHub, and the link is in the video description. I'll also demonstrate how this program works on this photo and on a more recent photo of the tilted horizontal moon. So here's the program in action. It's a simple command line interface. The first two numbers are the latitude and longitude of the observer, respectively. Keep in mind that positive latitude is north, negative latitude is south, positive longitude is east, and negative longitude is west. The third number is the altitude. In this case, this picture was taken in Florida, and I simply enter the altitude as zero, the altitude of the observer, that is. This picture was taken on December 31st, 1971. The format is year, month, day, and then the time in universal time, which in this case was about 2 hours, 45 minutes universal time. And then optionally, you can enter a final command, the file name of the picture you want to derotate. If you leave this blank, it will simply give you the numbers without attempting to derotate an image. So when you hit enter, it will return several lines of text. On the first line, it will give you the altitude and azimuth of the moon. This is the moon's actual position, and you can use this to point your telescope or camera at the moon if you desire. So once again, if you don't supply an image file name, it will simply give you the numbers, and you can use this predictively before the observation if you desire. The second line gives you the instantaneous rate of field rotation. In other words, the rate in degrees per hour that field rotation is changing at that location in the sky for that observer, the location of the moon at that time. Of course, this instantaneous rate of change is itself constantly changing as the moon is moving through the sky. But if you look at closely spaced points in time, what you'll see is that this rate of change matches the actual rate of change reflected in the actual field rotation angle that we'll get to later. The general formula for predicting the rate of field rotation is quite simple and can be found on the Royal Astronomical Society of Canada's Calgary website, and that is exactly what I've used in the source code of this program, as you can see up on GitHub. Next, we have the position angle of the moon's bright limb. This is the angle between the north point of the moon and the center of the moon's illuminated portion. In other words, a line pointing towards the sun. But for calculating the apparent orientation of the moon, what we're interested in really is the lunar terminator, the line that divides day and night on the moon. And so when we go to calculate the orientation of the moon, we actually add 90 degrees to this angle to get the angle of the lunar terminator. Next, we have the angle of field rotation. This is how much field rotation the moon is experiencing at that location in the sky for that observer. This field rotation angle is calculated by taking the center point of the moon in the equatorial coordinate system, adding its radius to the declination to find the northernmost point of the moon in the equatorial coordinate system, and then converting those coordinates from equatorial to altitude azimuth coordinates. The equatorial coordinate system is basically a polar aligned coordinate system, aligned to the Earth's axis of rotation with the north and south celestial pole, but it's tilted relative to the altitude azimuth coordinate system, which is why the blue grid here is tilted in this picture. So to calculate the field rotation angle, once we've converted the equatorial coordinates for the center and northernmost point of the moon to the altitude azimuth system, all we have to do is calculate the position angle of those coordinates in the altitude azimuth system, and that gives us the field rotation angle. Finally, we subtract the field rotation angle from the angle of the lunar terminator to determine the overall orientation of the moon, and this is the angle we must rotate the moon by to return it to an apparent vertical orientation as seen on the final line. The program I've written will automatically do this for you. It will derotate the image, display it, and save the derotated image with underscore derotated appended to the end of the file. Here's one more example image, a more recent example from 2014. This was a Creative Commons image that I found on Flickr, and I'll include the link to it in the video description. You can see also that I've calculated for two slightly different points in time, one without the image file name because that wasn't quite when the image was taken, it was 6 minutes before it was taken, or 1/10 of an hour, and you can see that the predicted rate of change of field rotation changed a little bit between those time points, but the average rate matches exactly what the actual change in field rotation turned out to be. We can also see that the program correctly derotated the image and returned the moon to its expected vertical orientation, using nothing but the observer's location near the Golden Gate Bridge and the time. So, as you can see, the program works quite well. We can see that field rotation is a normal and expected phenomenon, and that we can predict it mathematically. So, here's the source code for the program, and once again, you can, of course, download this on GitHub. But the real meat of it occurs up in the top section, where I define two main functions. The first one converts the right ascension and declination coordinates to altitude and azimuth, which is very important for calculating the field rotation. The second function calculates the position angle. This function is used twice, once to calculate the position angle of the moon's bright limb, and the second time to calculate the position angle of field rotation. Field rotation is an inevitable consequence of viewing the moon from a non-polar aligned perspective, and the way we normally view the sky, with our heads on top of our shoulders, it's a non-polar aligned perspective. In fact, we typically look at the sky relative to our local horizon, and so that is an altitude azimuth coordinate system, not a polar aligned coordinate system. That's why we see the effects of field rotation. If you have a polar aligned telescope, of course, you can compensate for that, but that's not how we normally see the sky on a day-to-day basis. Field rotation is not a new or unusual phenomenon. I showed you at the start of this video a picture of the horizontal moon taken in 1971, and I have even older photographs and pictures of it that I can show you later if you guys want. And as you can see by the calculations made in this video and with the program I've provided here, you can predict its occurrence and return pictures taken of the moon to a vertical orientation using nothing more than the observer's location and the time in less than 60 lines of code. Once again, you can find the source code and the program and the link to GitHub in the video description, and I'll be continuing to develop additional programs in the future as well. For example, I'm working on porting my Teletrack software for high-speed telescopic tracking with GoTo telescopes to other types of telescopes using ASCOM for telescopes that support the needed commands. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned for more. Clear skies, folks.